This is great.
If you weren't a man of remarkable integrity, I'd say you had some work down there, Brandon. Nice t-shirt.
Yeah, this t-shirt is part of our campaign. See, we're gonna kill global warming once and for all, right? Yeah.
What is that?
Yeah, see, we're gonna have a concert, get a lot of people together to really rally, you know, and feel the music and the message. And once you feel that, you'll wanna buy the t-shirt and the program, the commemorative DVD we're making, the limited edition MP3 player. And once we join together, all of us join together, global warming will end, man. Global warming will end. I mean, like, I'm no scientist, okay? But sometimes these scientists, they just make things confusing. This is about intelligent people like me making a difference at a ground level.
Wow, that sounds great, Brandon. I don't know if you're acting in a movie. Hey, Nico.
Hey.
Come in.
Thank you.
Lay off that stuff.
Why?
Because it clouds your judgment. Not now, it's not the time.
My judgment. That's a good one. I'm a fool. Drunken fool.
Nico's here. We're going to go take care of that guy. I take it you won't be joining us?
Make him suffer. People forget pain so quickly.
You need to calm down with that stuff.
Calm? Why? So I can be like you, Mr. Barbiturate? Always so fucked up on painkillers, you don't give a shit?
You need to calm down.
Where would we be now if I was calm like you?
Let me guess. In a prison camp in Siberia, or selling hash to tourists in Red Square, or still in the Navy. Which is it today?
Be careful, Dimitri. Be fucking careful.
You be careful. You're getting crazy.
That's the way it works. I am angry. You are calm. I scare you reason. It works.
Yes, but you've angered the wrong people.
Blah, blah,
too many
blah,
bodies,
blah,
too much blah, attention blah, blah, will be blah. Dealt with if we don't start playing by the rules.
I've angered people. Me? Not we. Strange. When I give out the money, it's us. When I have to push people, it's me. All alone. Don't think I cannot see through you. After all we've done together.
You're getting delusional. Look, we have to go.
I fucking love you.
Yes, yes.
I fucking love you.
I know.
Yeah. Yes. But you treat me like a child. I run things my way. Dmitry Raskolov, my fucking way! Get out of my sight! Or I fucking kill you!
I'm not saying don't run things your way. I'm saying be calm. Here. Take a couple of these.
What are you still doing here? I said get out of my sight!
We're going to that sex shop on Hove Beach.
On the Los Santos freeway and a huge monkey, some dinosaurs and a
this guy been making porno in his basement, and he didn't cut Mikhail in.
At least he could have done is sent over some tapes.
You know how much money there is in selling this stuff online? A whole fucking heap. We're going to ignore what Mikhail said and try not to kill them. Taking a bite of this pie would be very profitable for our operation.
I got no problem with sparing some lives.
No, it's Mikhail that has that issue. Can't keep his finger off of the triggers. Wasn't always like this, though. Things got to him.
I hope it don't get to me.
Return to the intelligent agenda.
Okay, we're back on the intelligent agenda with me, Mike Riley. Let's bring out our next guest.
State. You may have seen their TV commercials for John Hunter where he accuses Michael Graves of all kinds of nasty. Shut the fuck up.
You got a problem?
Yeah, I've seen this kid before.
Where's your boss?
What do you mean? He's,
in the back?
No, he's...
You better not be filming.
No, they're just having a meeting, I swear.
Get out of the way!
Fuck. You see? They don't make them like that no more. That's a vintage Bush. If it wasn't for that, I'd say this weren't worth transferring to DVD.
Hey, Joseph! You think you can expand your business interests, make these pornos and sell them,
and we won't know about it,
huh?
We was just waiting until the books was closed at the end of the financial year. Then we was gonna cut you
in. Your books are closed until you pay us our cut. Nico, take this and cover Joseph.
We ain't making that much cash.
Is that the... Listen, big guy, you got a great look going on. Real strong. We can push in one of our films.
Shoot this scumbag in the leg.
Hey, man, please, go easy on me. Come on, big guy.
Shoot him.
All right, already. Brett was just trying to be friendly. Shit, he'll be out of action for a couple of weeks.
You got some money for Mr. Faustin?
Fine, here you go. We ain't gonna have the...
You should have thought of that earlier.
Please don't hurt me! I'm an actor!
This is a mess. Let's get out of here. Ah! We're going to an alleyway off of Dillon Street in Chaplin.
Hey, baby.
I want to buy you a present.
Will you wrap it up and put a pretty bow on it?
Screw you. We're seeing a friend of mine who's got a good line on weapons. It's on the ground. A back room place. There are a few around the city. The mayor has a real hard-on for gun control.
Guns don't seem that controlled. I seen plenty and I just got here.
And now you'll know where to get them for yourself. What's the problem? Mikhail. Я знаю, что ты это не имел в виду. Все в порядке. I didn't kill Joseph. We will make more money with him alive. Черт, Михаил! Михаил! Fuck! You're lucky. Ramadan tried to make you kill someone every 2 seconds. The shop is just down that alleyway. Pick out what you like. Tell them to put it on Mr. Faustin's account.
All right. You don't look like a cop. Buy what you want.
I'll take this one. Charge Mr. Faustin.
You fucking Ruskies are milking me dry. I ain't a cow.
I ain't Russian.
Drive us to Mr. Faustin's.
Hey, how you doing?
Overregulated the insurance.
So, you and Mr. Faustin, have you always argued and made up like this?
It wasn't always like this. Mikhail was a great man. He had a temper, but he was fair. Now he blows his top at the slightest thing. I never know who he will shoot, who he will stab. Andrei, who you met in Mikhail's basement, he was always loyal. He was a good worker. Now he's dead. I guess that is why we need your help.
Remind Faustin of that. Maybe Danny will not try to kill me.
Speaking of kids, we should take a quick break and get our next guest out here. Get this, he's 11 and he's a super genius. Back after this.
Public Liberty Radio. Free radio. Free of interesting content. Just blather. Boring burnout. Blathering between shows. This is PLI.
Intelligent Agenda. I'm Mike Wiley. I'm sure you've heard about our next guest on the news. He's 11, and he's a genius. He's Zachary Tyler, National Spelling Bee champion a couple of years back, also a grandmaster at chess, and he's written the great American novel, and now he's about to solve hunger. Great to have you on the show.
Greetings.
Now, Zachary, you are...
Thank you for your help, Nico. Come to see us at the club soon. Mikhail will be cool by then.
I put myself up for adoption.
I'm a divorced dad in my new movie. It's got a talking car and a flesh-eating disease and threatens mankind, but I've got great abs in it. It's a real character piece.
Okay, Zach, you've been educated in a public school.
Well, sort of. I learned to despise the common herd in a public school. So then I learned about...